In this video, I will show you how to perform quantification measurements with the METTLER TOLEDO's EasyPlus UV VIS spectrophotometers. Quantification contains two different types of result calculation, by an own formula or by a calibration curve built up by measuring standards. I will show you how to perform both different types of quantification measurements. Let's start with the configuration. Click Quantification on the home screen. This opens a list of 20 predefined quantification methods. Each method can be adjusted individually and can be exported to a USB flash drive. To enter the method editor, just click on the Edit button and select your method. The method editor shows two tabs, General and Measurement. The General tab is the same for all categories. You can change, for example, the method name into blue. You can choose between different export options or define sample IDs. The Measurements tab is different for formula and calibration curve. Firstly, I will start with the explanation of formula. If you want, you can also jump directly to calibration curve. The Measurement tab contains all measurement information. First of all, you have to choose the calculation type. I'm now selecting formula. Additionally, you can define the path lengths. For example, fixed and 60 mm. Here, up to 5 measurement wavelengths can be defined. The measured absorbance and transmittance values can be used later in the calculation of the result. I will define 820 nanometers as a wavelength. With constants, you can define up to 10 constants, which can be used in the calculation afterwards. For the first constant, I'm defining 5.5. Sample factors are flexible constants, which are regressed before each measurement. You can define up to 3 of them and define also the name and the default value. For example, X name is weight. Last but not least, I can define the results where the formula can be input. This list can contain up to 4 results. For each result, name, unit, formula, limits and decimal places can be defined. The formula editor follows a building block logic. You have 4 buttons selecting your building blocks. The first one contains the measured absorbance and transmittance values. The second one, the previously defined constants. The third one offers mathematical operators. And the last one adds sample factors and brackets to your formula. By confirming the input, the formula is ready to use. Now, the method is completely defined and we are ready to perform the measurement. To start the method, I'm clicking the green Start button. The instrument now leads me through the whole workflow. First of all, the instrument is regressing the sample factor, which I define with 0.5. Afterwards, I need to perform the blank measurement. I follow the instructions shown on the screen and press the lid to open. I'm inserting the blank cuvette, close the lid, and the blank determination starts automatically. Now I'm asked to insert the sample. Let's open the lid again and replace the blank with the sample cuvette. I close the lid and the measurement starts immediately. And here is the result. To measure additional samples with the same settings, simply click the Start button again. I'm now again asked for the sample factor, and by confirming the input, the measurement starts automatically. That's because the blank measurement is stored for 7 days and no new blank determination is necessary, even if I'm leaving the method. Simply follow the instruction to continue with further measurements. Let's have a look how to set up a calibration curve. The measurement tab contains all measurement information. First of all, you have to choose the calculation type. I'm selecting calibration curve. Additionally, you have to define the path length. If I activate the background correction, I need to define the corresponding wavelength. The default value is 840 nanometers. A name and a unit can also be defined here. For example, yellow as a name. On the second page, I can define the decimal places. Here, you have to define the wavelength of interest. For example, 340 nanometers. For the curve, different fit types are available: linear, quadratic, or cubic. For a linear fit, I can also activate the setting force through zero. In the next step, I have to define the standards for the calibration curve. By clicking the Add button, I can define the first data point with a corresponding concentration, 5, and press afterwards the Start button. As no blank value is available, I have to measure the blank value first. Afterwards, the instrument is requesting for a standard solution. The result is shown and I'm confirming it. By returning to the list of data points, I can define more data points. Now I have finished with the data point measurements and can check the calibration curve formula here. Here we can see the formula and the R-square value. Now the method is completely defined and we are ready to perform the measurement. To start the method, I'm clicking the green Start button again. The instrument now leads me through the whole workflow. Now I'm asked to insert the sample. Let's open the lid again and I'm inserting the sample cuvette. I close the lid and the measurement starts immediately. And here is the result. To measure additional samples with the same settings, simply click the Start button again. I'm now directly asked to insert the sample. That's because the blank measurement is stored for 7 days and no new blank determination is necessary, even if I'm leaving the method. simply follow the instruction to continue with further measurements. I hope this short introduction into quantification measurements was helpful. Don't miss our other product training videos on photometric and scanning measurements, color determinations, and water testing. See you soon!